I'm Penny Carlson, and welcome to Topics in Digital Photography. Today I'm going to show you how to use layer masks in Photoshop to create a composite image. This photo is a composite photograph. This is Alex Tablan. Alex Tablan graduated from School of Environmental and Biological Sciences at Rutgers. Alex is an expert tree climber, and he took down this big tree that was just a little bit too close to my house. So here's a composite shot that shows him dropping this log. And what I did was set my camera up on a tripod and shot three shots in rapid succession, caught this log falling out of the tree.
To capture the action, you want to make sure that you have your camera in continuous shooting mode. Most cameras will have a dedicated drive button for this. Press the drive button, then access continuous shooting mode. When you take the picture, just hold down the shutter until the action's done.
So let's look at the original shots. I'm in Lightroom right now. Here's our first shot. Here's our second shot with the log just a little lower. And here's our third shot. So I'm going to combine these three shots in Photoshop so we can get a little bit of an idea of the action and see the succession of this log falling out of the tree.
In order to make it easy to line your shots up later in Photoshop, it's important that you use a tripod.
A tripod will keep your background the same in all three shots, and that'll let you line things up a lot easier. So let's get these photos into Photoshop. And we want to bring these photos into Photoshop as layers. And the easiest way to do that is to select all of them, right-click, go Edit In, and open them as layers in Photoshop. I use Lightroom to manage my photos and for a lot of my editing, but if you don't have Lightroom, you can use Adobe Bridge and open your photos into Photoshop that way. It's a lot easier than opening your photos separately and then merging them into layers. I'm using Adobe Creative Cloud, and this is not the absolute latest version. I haven't updated it on this computer. Takes a while for the photos to open, and I'll edit a lot of that out in my final video, so don't get worried if yours aren't opening as quickly. What we want to do to make sure that we're all working in the same workspace is to either use this little icon up here. That's actually changed in the most updated version of Photoshop Creative Cloud, and it's no longer there. So if you're working on any version, you can change your workspace or reset it by going into Windows, Workspace, and make sure you're working in the photography workspace, and just reset your workspace. I've done a lot of my earlier videos using Adobe CS6. I know some people are still using CS6. It'll look pretty much the same as this, but when you open the cloud-based programs, your library's on top. All you have to do is change your tab to Adjustments, and things should look pretty much the same in most versions of Adobe Photoshop. All right, you can see we've got our three layers. Okay, I can turn my top layer off. See, we get the next layer and then the final layer. I want to figure out which layer to use for my master layer by figuring out where Alex kind of looks best. I think it's going to work the most realistically if we use this top layer. Whatever layer you decide for your photo, you want that layer to be on top. And if it's not, you can move your layers. Now my second layer is on top. I don't want that. Let me put it back. If you've got a background layer, since I open it as layers, we don't have that. But if you have a background layer, it'll be locked. You'll have a little lock thing over to the right. You can simply unlock it, and then you can move that layer around also. So I'm going to start working with my top layer. And use the Control Plus to make my photo a little larger. And what I want to do is add a layer mask to this top layer. To do that, I just come down here. This is your layer mask icon. Click on that, and I've added the layer mask. Now you want to make sure your layer mask is selected. See how I just clicked over here? It's no longer selected. So I click here, got the white border around it. It's selected. And what we want to do to bring the layer out underneath is just paint in black on this top layer, and I'll let the layer below through. So before that, so I can see where I want to paint, I want to maybe see what's below, I'm just going to change the opacity. Just go up here to the opacity, hover over it. I've got my scrubby slider. And just bring it down till I can see that layer below. I'm going to use my paintbrush tool. It should be your top tool. If it's hidden, you just right click and bring up the brush tool. And let's look at some of your options up here. Your default brush tools are generally these round brush tools. You can either use a hard brush or a soft brush. I find different brushes work better for different applications with this. If the layers I want to show through are really close together, sometimes a hard brush will work better, or I'll get ghosting around the edges. But with this application, I think my soft brush will work better. That way, if we have trouble with alignments over by the house, it should blend in a little bit better. Your soft will blend things in a little better. The other thing we want to make sure is that we've got the black color up here. Okay, if you've got another color, you can click on it and bring the selection tool up and make sure you just select that black corner. If your white tool's on top, you can just click this arrow and see you can switch back and forth between white and black, which will be very useful here because sometimes we'll want to go back to the white. Let's get the right brush size so I can use my right or left bracket to change my brush size. I don't have to be real exact here because the pictures should be the same. I also want to bring some of that sawdust up, so I want to go up a bit. And once it's looking pretty good, we can go back to our opacity and change it back to 100%. We just put the opacity at a lower percentage so we could see that next layer coming through. I actually did this on purpose to show you how to correct it. Switch the hand tool. See how I went over my top log a little bit? I want to fix that. All right, so the way to fix that, click on our brush again, is to change your color down here to white. So the deal with layer masks is that the black brush reveals what's underneath, the white brush conceals what's underneath. And you could use a gray color if you wanted to let your layer partially through. Mostly you're going to use white and black for things like this. Now I'm just going to want to bring this layer back in. And that looks good. Let's blow this up a little bit. Make sure everything looks right. It's looking good. And make sure everything looks perfect because I haven't duplicated my layers here and I don't really think I need to. Instead of doing a layer, turning this off and doing a layer below to bring the lower layer through, we're just going to do it all on the top layer. So what I want to do is select my two layers, right click, and merge my layers. Okay, and here's my completed top layer. And it just makes it a little easier than trying to deal with the three layers successively. And then what I want to do is add another layer mask. Make sure my brush tool is on again. Bring my opacity down again so I can see that next layer coming through. Make sure I'm on black and go down over this next layer. Okay, bring my opacity back up. Hit Control minus or Command if you're on the Mac. Look at our final picture and everything looks great. Now if we want to edit our final picture a little bit more for color or something like that, we can do it in Photoshop or we can simply save it and go back in and do any edits in Lightroom. So we're going to call this Tossing Logs. And you can see I have the previous version that I showed you saved. We'll hit save. We can go back in and look at our photo in Lightroom. Okay, so that's it. It was really easy. If we want to crop and edit a little bit more in Lightroom, we can do that now. And here's what I came up with for my final photo after I did some editing and bumped the colors up a little bit. And we get a really nice action type photo that shows a little bit more about what's going on. Another great application for layer masks is if you take a group photo, you take a bunch of photos in succession and Aunt Sally looks great in one of the shots, but her eyes are closed in the next. Uncle Pete looks great in another shot, but he's frowning in the next. You can use layer masks to bring out the best in everybody.